Okay, ready? Sometimes on Sunday in my family, we have this thing our family calls snack supper. We open up the cupboards and the fridge and put out all these little bowls and plates of whatever we can find. Fruit, cheese, chopped vegetables that didn't get used that week, muffins, lunch meat, leftover soup, bread, sometimes olives and half-empty jars of sun-dried tomatoes and marinated artichoke hearts, cereal. And we just pick at it, like we're at a party, except half of us are usually in our pajamas. It's a communion table. If people drop in, they just grab a little saucer, the mismatched ones we bought at the charity shop, and fill up. There's always enough, and everyone is welcome. Yesterday, I had a pub breakfast in town at the River or Wilson, ordering up our full English at the bar with a long-lashed girl. I traced my hand on the thick varnish of the bar and looked at the spotlight sparkling through the glass bottles. You know the ones, Gordon's green and sapphire blue, Jack Daniel's amber and Absolute crystal. And I remembered my first snack suppers, those years ago when Dad would take us on a Sunday afternoon on the way to Grandma's to the old taverns in Wisconsin. The ones next to the fishing bait shops that were open all day and all night, and yes, even on Sundays. Well, by the time Dad was on his second or third, the bartender would almost always offer up a Shirley Temple cocktail or a Coke on the house. If we sat there long enough and the bar was empty enough, Bobby and I got an invitation, an open invitation to the mother load. The stainless steel trays with neat little square compartments of green olives, chemical red maraschino cherries with the stem still on. Later, I would master tying those in a knot with my tongue, which impressed childhood and university friends alike, but that's a whole other Oprah. Orange slices, sour lemon wedges, limes, tiny onions the size of gumballs. Snack, supper. The first place I saw compassion in a stranger's eyes was at those little joints, the bartender's way of sliding the tray in front of us or refilling our cokes while Dad talked about the old neighborhood, the ladies, and baseball. Later, a soft look like that would come from our teachers. Officer Friendly, the police officer who visited our class the same week, he had to arrest my dad for taking a belt buckle to my mom's face. I would see compassion like I saw in those old taverns on Mrs. Kappa's face when she pulled over to offer me a ride home from school when Dad forgot because he was sleeping one off and Mom was at work. I always said no because my boots were soaked through with melted, even though my boots were soaked through with melted snow. We went to church too, but compassion didn't live there like it did in the taverns. After my mom and dad got divorced the first time, the pastor walked us out to the car from Vacation Bible School, where we ate pistachio pudding and made newspaper hats and played London Bridge is Falling Down and pasted on the words Jesus loves me over our name scrawled in red crayon, the pasted on tear-up face of Jesus in comic book sketch, had more compassion that day than the man who smelled like the Vitalis Dad left on the bathroom shelf when he moved out. The man we call Pastor and Sir. The guy who taught us that song, Jesus Loves Me. That guy. He walked us out to Mom's old Chevy one day while she was sitting there waiting for us, a single string of smoke rising in the summer sky from her rolled-down window. He talked to Mom with a sort of kindness in his voice that felt more like winter ice than any summer I remember. And he looked down when he spoke, and she said, I'm sorry and thank you. And we drove away, and we didn't ever go back. Later, over breakfast at IHOP when I was at uni, Mom would tell me what that pastor guy said. Something about not being a babysitter service. About D-I-V-O-R-C-E, about that place being a family church. I guess we didn't qualify. Nobody ever spoke like that in the bars. They laughed, and they told their stories, passed me quarters for the jukebox. The ladies would touch my little girl hair and let me sit on their laps. And you know, they'd say I was something special with dancer's legs and my dad's eyes. And the smoke would swirl around under the lights until last calls. Thank you. everybody. Fantastic.